Hey everyone, Julie here with Equip the Light, where we equip you with the knowledge of Jesus and His Word so that you can know Him and walk in the calling that He has for you. Please subscribe and hit the notification bell if you haven't already. And please put your comments and questions in the comments below. And please share and like this video. You can find the free Bible study worksheets at our website at equipthelight.com. Just click on the store link, scroll to the bottom, and you should be able to find them. Today we're going over the question answers for day 5 of week 1 in the John Bible study. We're going to be talking about how Jesus explained or revealed the Father in John chapter 1, verse 18. Coming up next. Dear Lord, I praise and honor you, Father. I pray for everyone here watching today, God. I pray that you will reveal your word to us, God. Help us to hide it in our heart so that we will always live for you. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. All right, so today we're talking about John 1:18. So let's go ahead and read that. No one has seen God at any time, the only begotten God, who is in the bosom of the Father. He has explained him. Question 24 states, who has seen God the Father? And if we look at the verse, okay, so this says, no one has seen God at any time, the only begotten God who is in the bosom of the Father, he has explained him. So here the answer is Jesus. All right, number 25, what kind of relationship between Jesus and the Father do the words in the bosom of the Father portray? Well, you think about, you know, basically he's leaning back on the Father, and in rest and peace and joy, and that sort of just shows there's a loving relationship there. And it's interesting because John, the author of this book, is known for laying back in Jesus's bosom. So it's sort of like the same relationship that Jesus had with God is mirrored in John, the author's relationship with Jesus. And I think that's where we all want to be, right? Okay, number 26 states that Jesus has explained God. How would Jesus, the Word coming to earth as a human being, communicate to us what the Father is like? Okay, so the word explain here in Greek means to declare. So Jesus declared who the Father is to us. So humans, Adam and Eve, they used to walk with God before the fall, but then after the fall, our sin separated us from God because God is so holy that anybody with sin that comes in His presence would basically die. So in the past, God was distant and His holiness and our sin separated us from each other. And the only thing people really had to go by for Jesus's time were the scriptures and the signs and prophets. But Jesus came to earth and He wanted to show who His Father really was. And God really wanted to show who He was in His heart for us. So number 27, how does Jesus coming to earth as a human help us relate to God and God relate to us? So when Jesus came down, He showed us grace and truth, not condemnation. He said, I came into the world to seek and save those that were lost. So Jesus really revealed the heart of the Father to us. And we know that God loves us. And God wanted to be reconciled to us so much that He gave up His only begotten Son for us, that we could have relationship with Him again. Number 28, can we know God without knowing Jesus? Why? So the answer to this question is no, because Jesus was the mediator between us and God. And Jesus said in John 14:6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but through me. If you had known me, you would have known my Father also. From now on, you know Him and have seen Him. We can only get to God through Jesus. And so you can't go around Jesus to get to God. He is the way. He is the truth and the life. And He is the one that gets us to God. And for a cross-reference, if we look at Hebrews 4:15, which states, for we do not have a high priest who cannot sympathize with our weaknesses, but one who has been tempted in all things as we are, yet without sin. This is talking about Jesus, how He became our priest, how He became the intermediary between us and God. And because He lived His life as a human and was tempted in every way that we are, He is able to sympathize with our weaknesses. So Jesus' coming to earth also helped God relate to us. So we have some discussion questions, and number one asks, if you're a child of God, how does God feel towards you compared to Jesus in light of the fact he sent his only child to earth to die for us? If we are his children, how should we approach God? So a really awesome verse is in 1 John 4:9-10, which go to the back of the book, kind of more towards Revelation. And it says, by this, the love of God was manifested in us, that God has sent his only begotten Son into the world so that we might live through him. In this is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the propitiation for our sins. This is saying that God is love, and his love for us was manifested in the fact that he gave up his Son for us. Another awesome verse is in Romans 8:32, which says, he who did not spare his own Son, but delivered him over for us all, how will he not also with him freely give us all things? So it's just, again, showing that God loved us so much that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him won't perish but have eternal life. And that is the message of reconciliation with God. God loves us. It's not just Jesus loved us, but God the Father loves us. We need to recognize that God really loves us. We need to recognize that he is no respecter of persons. He loves every single person because he helped create every single person. And God is for us, and he wants to treat us like his children. He wants to freely give us all things according to his will. Discussion question number two, if Jesus had not come to earth in the flesh and you only had the Old Testament scriptures, would you perceive God differently and why? I think if Jesus hadn't have come to earth, we would have only seen the Old Testament scriptures. We would have only seen perhaps the wrath and condemnation of God. Even though there are many instances, for example, in Psalms showing God's love, there are instances of God sparing people, of God trying to make a way for people, but I think the majority of people would just take it that he's somebody to be feared. And just as we discussed yesterday, God didn't give the law to people, giving them something that they could never achieve, but he was giving them the law so that they would recognize they could never fulfill it in their own strength and will, and that they needed a savior. And if you look at Romans 5:8-10, it says, but God demonstrates his own love toward us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. How much more then, having now been justified by his blood, we shall be saved from the wrath of God through him. For if while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his Son, how much more, having been reconciled, shall we be saved by his life? So we can be confident that God loves us, that he would send his Son to die for us even when we were sinners. And now being justified by his blood, we have confidence that we will be saved through Jesus. And once being enemies of God, we were reconciled to God through the death of Jesus. So how much more will we be saved through his life? And one more verse I want to share with you is 1 John 3:1. See how great a love the Father has bestowed on us, that we would be called children of God, and such we are. For this reason, the world does not know us because it did not know him. Beloved, now we are children of God, and it has not appeared as yet what we will be. We know that when he appears, we will be like him because we will see him just as he is. And everyone who has this hope fixed on him purifies himself just as he is pure. So God's love for us is so great and incomprehensible, really, because he sent his only Son so that we could become his children. And being a child of God, we will one day see him as he really is, and seeing him, we will become like him. Uniting with God in this way, this is the hope that we believers have. And so we're going to continue walking with God and continue learning the word every day. We've really become adopted spiritual children of God. And so we can call God our Abba, our Father, just the way Jesus called God his Abba Father. So that's all I have for today. I will see you next week for week 2's introduction and day 1 study. Have a great day.
Equip the Light wants to equip you with the knowledge of Jesus and His Word so that you can know Him and step into the calling that He's called you to. If you like this video, please subscribe and hit the like button. Thanks, everyone.
I've got big news. My book, The Unlocking, is out and available for purchase. It's an action-adventure fantasy novel about the end of the world through the eyes of an 11-year-old girl. It's funny, exciting, and you won't want to put it down. Enjoy!
And if you take a look also at Romans. Romans, 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 Romans.